So let's go with these laws of nature first. Let's do laws of nature. Laws of nature. Now, you needn't have gone to university or to college to know Newton's three laws. Laws of motion, those are laws of nature. And we can have a look at Newton's second law. Let's say Newton's second law. You can say, well, F equals ma, and we can make this a vector and a a vector. I mean, you just learned that. That's just the way it is. But how can you come up with this as a physicist? Well, you don't know that this is the relationship. You don't know what a force is, but you see acceleration. You notice when you're Galileo that if you drop something, it falls, it goes faster and faster. If you roll a ball down an incline, it goes faster and faster. There's some acceleration. And so, you know that acceleration exists. It's a vector because it has quantity, it has size, and it has a direction. And you think to yourself, let's make a proportionality. Let's make it proportional to something, and we call that something a force, which is also a direction. Now you've got a choice. You can say, well, let's make it inversely proportional. Let's make it proportional to the square, this thing that we created. We call it proportional to the square of the acceleration. There's lots of things you can come up with. But let's start simple, and we just say, well, it's just proportional. And if that's a linear proportionality, remember it's linear, that's to the power 1, that's to the power 1, it's not inverse. It's just linear proportionality. You can put in, let's just write things the proper way around. So you say if it's proportional to the acceleration. Now you can put in a constant of proportionality, and let's call that inertia, inertial mass. You say, that looks good. Let's try and test this. I have an effect, and I have a cause. And I can change that cause. I can push something, and I can now change this proportionality and see if this constant of proportionality, see if my effect is different. I can now go out and test this. And if I do lots of tests and I can find no experiment that proves otherwise, I accept this as a law of nature. That is a law of nature. And no one has ever found within the realms of classical mechanics. Now if you're interested in physics, if you know anything about it, you'll know that this is just a very special case. We're talking Newton's laws are just a special case of in various circumstances, say for instance of general relativity, and you know that's not completely true, that there's a warping of space-time due to a large gravitational mass or large mass. But within the realms of classical mechanics, no experiment has ever found anything different, and we now call it a law of nature. Now we go to the first law, and this should actually be called Galileo's law. He stated this, and then some suggest, well, you just set this equal to zero. Remember, acceleration is dv dt, and if that's zero, the only way that the derivative of something is zero vector, the only thing that its first derivative is zero is if that velocity is a constant. The constant is either zero, so the object is standing still, or it's some value, so there's linear motion in the same direction at the same velocity. We call that Newton's first law. But that's not Newton's first law, that's a derivation of the second law. If it's just simply a derivation, why do we call it a law at all? It is a law for a specific reason. Because it sets the existence of an inertial reference frame. And an inertial reference frame is something in which equilibrium holds. So you've created this a law, you've created this circumstance, you call it the first law. Under those circumstances, a type of space in which equilibrium holds. In other words, you need no cause to give you the effect of something standing still or going at constant velocity. You need no interference with that. If you create a system, a universe like that, that is a law of nature, and it has nothing to do with this derivation. It stands completely on its own. In the next section, we'll have a quick look at Newton's third law.